Okay, this is gonna be super fast because it's super hot in here, and if I turn the air conditioning on, it gets really loud and you can't hear anything. So real quick, a couple updates. First I wanna do reviews on the Olaplex, which I think I have right here. This is, I don't know if you can see how much I've done, not quite, but about a month. And I mean, I'm super happy with it. Like, I think my hair, I am more happy about it now than I have ever, like, not ever, but like since I was like younger and had the younger hair. Like, I am more satisfied with the quality and health of my hair after using this. So I definitely would highly recommend this. And I didn't have any kind of like crazy disciplinary where I was doing it every blah 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 blah. I just kind of just, I did a couple overnights and two where I just left it in and then took it out. And I'm probably gonna do that again tonight, is just like put it in and take it out. And then I also did the purple shampoo, which I honestly can see a little bit of the a difference. I don't see the brassiness that was kicking a little bit earlier. You can see, got my, somebody put in the comments, my money marks. I think that's what it was, with my little streaks out today. And I definitely am gonna keep this in the, and I have been mixing it in with my shampoo. So I'm not doing it just straight out of the bottle. I am putting a little bit of my shampoo because it's not that sudsy. Neither is my shampoo, but mixing them together, I feel like I'm still kind of getting the result that I want. Plus I'm getting, like, feeling like my hair is getting clean as well. So anyway, that one is a definite keeper. And the Olaplex, I gotta say, it's really great. I mean, this is again day old hair. Sorry, I seem to always give you guys day old hair, but I think it's more realistic. Sometimes I just like my hair when it's, you know, got at least a day of wear in it. I think it just lays better. I mean, but I'm really, you can really see the lowlights and how those kind of broke up. So you can really see over here, but see, if I lift that up, it's really, the lowlights are just kind of on the top right there, just to kind of break that up. But I mean, I think the last time that I did a full color on my hair was last September. So, I mean, so then you think, you know, it wasn't until probably the beginning of October that it was like starting to kind of grow out. So I don't know if you consider the last time that you color it as, I mean, I guess so, September. So, you know, we're approaching the year, I guess we'll be, so how many months is that? So let's think about that. So what is it? September. So like September, October, November, December, January, February, March, April, May, June. So I'm about 8 months. I mean, I guess kind of technically 9, if you consider from like the point where it starts coming out and where you get that anxiety where, you know, you would be using that root cover up and stuff like that. So I'm definitely past the point of it looking like, oh, I just haven't gone to the hairdresser. Like, it definitely looks intentional. And I gotta say, I'm loving it. And I don't know, again, if it's just because I had dark hair for so long that it's just so cool for me. I just like having the dimension and just to do something a little different. And I like how it kind of pulls through down here. And I just love that my hair is so, so much healthier. Like, I'm not going back. I'm definitely gonna, you know, keep going. So, on to randomness. If you're not a follower, click on there. And because this is my so-called reality, I should have probably done that on my intro. I'm working on my channel. But my goal with this channel is, I had a lot of insecurity as far as wanting to go gray, but having the societal thing of, you know, I'm going to be considered lazy. I need to keep up with this stuff. And there was a lot of insecurity. So now I'm not only taking full force on this gray hair, I guess, transition and story, but I'm also going to see what else I can do. So I'm not, it's almost empowered me in so many different ways, because it's a, I mean, just these money streaks. Like, I have been coloring them forever. I could have been rocking them, you know, a lot longer, but I was so scared that I didn't even take a chance. So now, my goal on this channel is to see what else I can do all while my hair is going gray. And so recently I earmuffs said, fuck the 9-to-5 job. And I decided that I was going to, apply for this gelato chef position. It's actually an apprentice, a gelato chef apprentice position. I'm getting hot. Anyway, and super overqualified, got the job. I have been working there a couple days a week. I've also went on to YouTube, because why, I don't even know why you need to go to college if you have YouTube now. And I just said, hey, I want to know, give me like 5 of the new apps that I could make some side money. So I chose the Amazon Flex, so I'm doing that, and I'm also doing Shipt, which is Shipt with a T. The difference is the Amazon, I actually live across the street from a Whole Foods, so the Amazon Flex is kind of like a little bit of everything, but I can turn on that app and immediately get something across the street to go pick up groceries and deliver them in the morning. So between that and the Shipt, which is more, Shipt is more like grocery shopping, kind of like Instacart, but it gives you the map and you can kind of evaluate everything to see if it's really worth your time doing it. So those two have been great. And then this gelato, and the gelato place has been awesome up until yesterday. I had a weird, I don't know if it was weird or maybe I'm just thinking it's weird. So I don't know. I feel like I'm gonna, you know, tell you the story and you tell me if I'm like reading into it or if that's a little weird. But let me preface this by saying that there are a ton of jobs out there. Like, there's so many jobs, like maybe they're not the best paying jobs, but if you want to work, there are plenty of people hiring. And so with that being said, I was having this discussion with myself this morning of there's a difference between help wanted and now hiring. And I feel like everything was really going great with this gelato place. The whole point of doing something like that was more back to my restaurant days of kind of just wanting something where I could just go in, do my thing, kind of a meditative thing, make this ice cream, learn skills about prepping, about franchises, all, you know, some stuff like that, that I could, you know, you can pretty much take any skill that you learn from any job and take it anywhere and apply it if you're paying attention, at least in my opinion, lessons. So anyway, I've been enjoying this job. I've kind of been working with this one other dude, and we just kind of come in the morning. The place doesn't even really open until 11. I'm like super early bird. My internal alarm clock goes off at 4:45 every day. Doesn't matter if I go to bed at 8, go to bed at 10, it's still 4:45. So it's been nice to be there early working with this guy and getting stuff done. Well, the owner, so there's a husband and wife, and then they have two girls, two daughters that kind of run this, a couple different locations. Anyway, so the big daddy came in, and when I say big daddy, I mean, he is a big daddy. I mean, he's a big guy. He's tall and he's large. And I had seen him a few other times, and he had reminded me of another guy that I used to work with that unfortunately is no longer here, but they share the same name. So you know how sometimes you kind of like give those attributes of thing when you see somebody that reminds you of someone, you kind of automatically give them the attributes then maybe they should or shouldn't have, but it's just kind of like a familiarity thing. Anyway, so I met him briefly, and then he came back in yesterday, and he didn't have the code to the door. So he's knocking on the door. I open the door. I let him in to the back door. So as he's kind of mulling around, supposedly he had a few things that he was going to drop off. But he kind of just like rolls around. Well, then he pulls a bar stool basically from this side part by the kitchen. Now, mind you, this is a tiny kitchen, And he pulls this bar stool up and he sits it right at an angle where he's just staring at my workstation. So now, mind you, it's kind of like an island and the other guy's on one side, I'm on my side, and I'm kind of mixing these flavors. I've got a scale, I'm kind of like focused here, and here he is kind of on this side here, and he's just kind of, you know, not helping, not prepping, not any, you know, and he just starts asking some questions and he's kind of going through his phone and he's telling me about how he's on this Nextdoor app, and then he kind of gives me this dad joke thing, and he's still, you know, just kind of staring right there. And it took him a long time to find, he was looking for the joke and then couldn't find it. So then he kind of paraphrased it. So within this time frame that he's doing this, he also brings the attention that there's a couple of holes, like where the tiles have been moved out from above the, you know, in the ceiling, like that looked like to me, and what the guy that I've been working with, he said that there was a leak. So they looked like that they had maybe fixed some pipes or whatever. Well, he goes on to proceed to tell me that one of the, I would say probably girls, cause it's more younger, like high school, maybe beginning college. It's kind of like a, that kind of a place, you know. Oh, I'm sweating. I'm gonna have to get off here, out of here soon. Anyway, that she had quit because she thought that there were cameras in these holes, and a couple of these holes happened to be in the bathroom. Now, why the hell you would come in and tell a new employee that's only been working for 3 weeks that somebody quit? So, I mean, part of me wants to go on to, you know, maybe I need to go on to Yelp and see if there's some creepy comments. But I was like totally taken back by A, that whole scenario. Then he walks me out to the front to point out a couple of cameras, and that he had seen roaches go by these cameras. So I don't know about you, but how fucking long are you sticking around cameras to realize? Okay, I had to turn it off. I got the emergency alert that the iPhone was going to explode. So I'm going to be really quick on this. So anyway, he shows me where this cockroach had gone across the, you know, the front of this camera. And I'm thinking to myself, like, do you, you know, because when he was saying, first of all, like, how long are you sitting in front of this camera that you're noticing these big roaches? The second of all, if you're noticing big roaches, how come in the month that I've worked there, you haven't cleared up these holes? B, and why are you coming in and telling this new employee about some shit that went down when nobody's asking, and it's weird. So either there's some, maybe some chatter online that I'm not paying attention to, but also, I don't know. My gut is kind of saying this could be a creepy dude and this could be a creepy situation. So I'm like, fuck, I just left the, you know, the other job because I thought it was a creepy situation, and you know, I'm doing this, so I have the backup with the Amazon Flex and the other stuff that I can do. But I just find it weird that this guy's like just staring at me, A, B, asking these weird questions, and then it was like C, kind of like, here, I want you to, I don't know if you've noticed that there's cameras, but the dude that I've been working with told me about the cameras right away, so I've been paying attention to that right away. So, yeah. And as I'm, again, just like the other place, as I'm asking everybody how long they've worked there, nobody's really worked there that long. There's only like one dude or one chick that's been there a year. So even the gelato chef guy who I've been working with, he's only been there since November. So going back to the help wanted and now hiring, do you want help? Because, you know, here I am doing this job because I don't, it's literally, I can walk there and it's just giving me like a meditative thing. But yesterday, you know, I'm there from 8:30 to 5:30, no break. The guy did end up sending some pizzas, but I thought it was odd that he sent pizzas after, you know, the chef guy that I'm working with was like, he made a comment, well, I'm still waiting on those pizzas or something like that. And then all of a sudden these two pizzas came. So there's some animosity that I was just picking up some stuff that that was rubbing me a little weird. So between the creepy looking at me like I'm prey. Like, if you are an attractive woman, you know what that is like. And then the other thing is that the other sister came in who does the scheduling. The one sister that I work with is awesome. I think she's great. The other sister came in that does the scheduling, and I was clear with her. I only wanted part-time. So part-time to me was 20 hours. 40 hours is full-time. 20 hours is part-time. I don't make enough money because not only is it's minimum wage. So minus your taxes, you're, you know, making 10 bucks an hour out there if you're lucky. So they're not just asking to be a gelato chef. They yesterday had asked the other chef to climb up on a ladder and unscrew this vent back to the ceiling and to take it down and hose it off. So not only do they want chefs, they want you working the entire 8-hour shift with no break, and they want somebody to clean their shit for them. So we're talking like I had to bleach the walls down and stuff like that. So, you know, that isn't what I signed up for. Normally I would not be that type of person, but when you're signed up to be a gelato chef, yes, I'll clean up my space. I'll clean up a little bit, but the stuff that they're asking for minimum wage is above and beyond. So yes, they are hiring, but they're hiring to replace 5 people's jobs. And so I'm kind of going back and forth, but if I do want to open my own food truck, which is what I do want to do, then maybe I shouldn't waste any more time there, and I should spend it more on the Amazon Flex to make the cash in order to get my little food truck deal so that I can start that going. So that's kind of the motivation that we're going to, but you tell me in the comments. I mean, do you think that that's creepy that the guy, like I literally met one time, brings out a stool and just sits down and stares at me, and it was, I don't know. Maybe he was trying to be friendly, but you know, the other thing, he was like, I got 99 problems. We all have the same problems. And then he was talking about trying to drop some Buddhist shit on me, which it's like, I don't know. It's like, I think you have to have a rapport with somebody before you can kind of come in and throw your weight around, like a lot of weight around, because it's just the polite thing to do, in my opinion. And this goes back to values. It's so nice to have values, because then when somebody rubs you the wrong way, you realize they're running up against a value. And then you can push on it a little bit. It's the respect. It was the balance. It was his lack of humor. You know, why would you come in and talk about rats and cockroaches? That's a very bizarre thing. But anyway. Thank you for watching. Please hit the button, like, subscribe, all that jazz. And let's see if we can get ourselves a food truck at the farmer's market, because that's, you know, kind of more of the direction that I would like all of us to go into. So thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And have a great, what is today? It's Monday. I was supposed to do this on Friday, but I got a little sidetracked, so now it's Monday. So thank you.